Let's speak about BioLase, baby. What is happening, investors? It is your boy Jack. I am not a financial advisor. I got the clothing line to prove that fact. And today we have to speak about one of our favorite penny stocks. So BioLase is a company I have covered in the past in detail. I believe I have a 15 or 16 minute video on the company going through all of the basics, all of the DD. And there's been a common theme with this company since I've started covering them, okay? So I got in at 102. It must have been somewhere around here. The company quickly made highs of 150 a few days after I got in, but it also has been coming down steadily since, and it's at about 110 a share. You will see in the pre-market, they're up close to 15%. They've been up as much as 20%. And it comes down to one piece of news. And that is this right here. BioLase regains compliance with NASDAQ minimum bid price requirement and cancels special meeting of stockholders. Now, this here was in relation to a reverse split vote. If I bring you back to this 6 month chart, you will see that, you know, for the majority of the past 6 months, this company has been between, let's say, 25 cents and 45 cents a share. So in order to remain listed on the NASDAQ, they had to maintain a price above $1 a share for a particular period of time. And so a lot of us were investing in hopes that we would maintain NASDAQ compliance without having to do this reverse split. It was a 25 to 1 split, and nobody really wanted it to happen at all, my friends. And that is the reason for this pre-market move right now, and I think it's only getting started in all honesty. So that is the primary thing we're going to speak about today, the fact that they have regained compliance with the NASDAQ, and what I think that means for the company going forwards, and what I think I could see happening price action-wise go forwards. On top of that, I just want to remind you guys of this. They bet the revenue consensus of $7.43 million in their preliminary Q4 reports, and it just goes to show how good of a position these guys are in right now. A few other press releases over the past 2 months or so that just show that this company is doing really well. And then of course, as always, we're going to have a look at the stock chart. We're going to see what the charts are telling us. And we're going to try and decide whether or not we believe Bio can make a very nice run to the upside. So my friends, right before we do get into the video, can I please ask you to hit that juicy like button. Drop me a comment down below. How many shares of this company do you own, and at what price did you buy? I know there's a lot of you guys who got in way before I did. And please, my friend, if you are indeed new around here, hit that juicy red subscribe button and join the family of investors, baby. We're trying to get to 100,000. We're getting close to 90. And if you are interested in joining my private Discord group, that's the first link in the description. In there, you get access to all of my buy and sell alerts, my long-term investments and my swing trades. I'm up over 20% on the week so far. It's been insane. I called BioLase at 102 in that group. We've traded loads of other penny stocks, particularly over last month. And I have a challenge starting next week, which is going to be very exciting. Also, if you'd like a couple of free stocks on Webull, that's the second link in the description. You gotta sign up and deposit $100. You get some free money for yourself, baby. Easy money. So let's start it off right here and just have a good look through the press release, okay? BioLase regains compliance with NASDAQ minimum bid price requirement and cancels a special meeting of stockholders. So BioLase had previously received written notice from the NASDAQ in December 2019, indicating that because the closing bid price per share had been below $1 for a period of 30 consecutive trading days, the company did not meet minimum bid requirement. However, for the last 10 consecutive business days from January 21st to February 3rd, the closing bid price of the company's common stock has been at $1 per share or greater, and the company has regained compliance. The company has cancelled its special meeting of stockholders scheduled for February 16th. As a result of regaining compliance with the minimum bid requirement, the company is no longer seeking stockholder approval to implement a reverse split. Now, the reason this is so significant is because obviously this company wanted to remain on the NASDAQ, and it was looking like the only way they were going to be able to do so was by a reverse split. As recently as February 1st, they let out a press release urging stockholders to vote for the reverse split. Initially, January 22nd, they held this special meeting, but they did not get the votes because you, me, the investors in this company, did not want the split to happen, okay? And then it was meant to reconvene on Tuesday, February 16th, 2021, where BioLase was urging everybody to vote in favor of the stock split. And again, I understand why they were. They wanted to keep NASDAQ compliance. We didn't want the split to happen. Now it doesn't have to. I think this is genuinely going to be a very large short-term catalyst for this company. I know that over the last 6 months, look, they've already had a really nice run-up, especially when you can say that the majority of this started happening at the end of December. They're up over 30% since then. 300%, not 30%, apologies. I still think this genuinely is the beginning for this company. When I initially invested in these guys, I planned to swing them, okay? And I was up about 50%. And I didn't take anything off the table because the more I looked into them, the more I just really loved the actual company, more so than I love the thoughts of the swing trade. So this is the biggest piece of news. This is what is moving us in the pre-market hours. And I genuinely think that that when the market opens, a lot of people are going to want to get involved here. But they're not just going to get involved because of the split, okay? I think that the split was putting a lot of new people from getting involved in this company, okay? You see pieces of news like this. BioLase rallies on beating revenue consensus of 7.43 million. Their preliminary total revenue is expected to be in the range of 8.2 to 8.5 million. I mean, they absolutely smashed the consensus. They didn't just, you know, scrape by. They didn't just beat it. They smashed through it. And that represents quarter-over-quarter growth of 26 to 31%. I mean, these guys are growing quick, my friends. I'd like to remind you guys as well, they are a global leader in dental lasers. They have approximately 271 patented and 40 patent-pending technologies designed to provide biologically and clinically superior performance with less pain and faster recovery time. They have sold, my friends, over 41,200 laser systems to date in over 80 countries around the world, and they are doing so well as of late. Another piece of news, we got January 12th, okay? Just to show you guys how much good news has been coming out, BioLase announces agreement with DSO Dental Care Alliance to expand laser adoption in dental offices across the United States. These are one of the largest dental support organizations in the United States, with more than 330 affiliated practices in 20 states, okay? That's a lot, and I mean a lot of new customers. That's a lot of new money coming in for this company, and when they are already, you know, seeing 25 plus percent growth quarter over quarter and beating estimates, that's something you gotta love to see, my friends. So Q4 US revenue exceeded year over year despite Roni headwinds. 78% of sales came from new users, continuing a positive trend. Furthermore, 40% of sales came from specialists, a significant increase compared to recent prior periods. You love to see it, my friends. Now we'll have a quick look at the actual chart, so you can see that pre-market, as I'm recording this video, we're at 129, and I mean the highest we hit was about 131, 132 in the pre-market hours. It's a very nice jump, okay? Now you can see this company, we have ups, we have downs, consolidation. We have ups, we have downs, somewhat consolidation, more of an upward move. Up, down, consolidation. I think we're starting our next nice leg up. Now of course there's no guarantees, it could be a little bit slower and steadier than these absolutely huge jumps here. But if history is to repeat itself, I definitely think we can go and break through that 150 mark very soon. And again, this is largely due to psychological reasons. I know for a fact there was a lot of people who were afraid to get into these guys in case the reverse split went through, because that more than likely would have led to a decent sell-off in price. So a lot of those kind of guys are going to be willing to get into this company now, my friends. But genuinely, I think this is so much more than a week-long swing trade. I think even if you're willing to hold these guys for another one, two, maybe three quarters at least, you're going to make a lot of money. And I'm going to be completely honest, my friends, these guys could stay in my long-term portfolio for a lot longer than I'm planning. You know, if I go up a couple hundred percent, I more than likely will take out my initial investment, but I think they have an awful lot of long-term potential. This is a company who, you know, has had its ups and downs. It's a company who did get hit considerably hard by the Roni, in all honesty, but they have bounced back very quickly. They have been releasing lots of good press, lots of good PR. They're beating earnings. They are selling more. It's awesome. Everything adds up. So our market cap is at about 137 million. I mean, yeah, maybe it's a little bit high compared to our revenues. It is what it is. I don't think it's absolutely terrible. But this news is quite big. But there's one thing I always like to point out. It's a fact that I absolutely love. Current all tissue laser market penetration. Very small. Every 1% increase in adoption in the US equals over $50 million in revenue for BioLase. I mean, it's going to come, my friends. They're going to grow literally absolutely everything that they can. They are not a one-trick pony. They do it all. If dentists need it, BioLase are going to offer it. They have this awesome partnership program where they enable customers to generate revenue without any cash outflow in 2020. They put money into the customer's pockets now, right off the entire amount without making any payments till 2021. They work with people. I mean, they make it so easy to work with them. The business model is fantastic. But my friends, that is my video on Bio. That is my update on what I'm doing. So, you know, when market opens today, I'm probably going to be up 20 to 30, maybe 40%, depending on how things go. I don't plan on selling anything, my friends, so you're all aware. But it definitely is something I'm thinking about. If you watch this video all the way till the end, you, my friend, are a true legend, and I really do appreciate you being here from the bottom of my heart. Your support means the world to me. If you did enjoy the video, could I please ask you to hit that juicy like button, drop me that comment down below, and please, my friend, subscribe if you're new around here. Also, if you are interested in that private Discord group, it is the first link in the description. It is such a juicy community, over 2,500 investors, all of my buy and sell alerts. We got in BioLase, we got in a lot of good penny stocks last month, and we're going to really kick it up a notch next week. If you want those free stocks on Webull, that's the second link. Anyway, guys, I hope you all have a beautiful, blessed day. I'll see you in another video very soon. Peace.